Here are 5 tips for moving up to Legend in Cataclysm. Number 1 is to match your talents and weapons. The most important thing in higher difficulties, barring knowledge, is ensuring the build you're running doesn't clash with but complements each other. This is especially true for your stagger talents and temp HP generation talents, which you should always take a look at before you go in a game to make sure that they work with the weapon that you are planning to use. Picking the wrong temp HP talent for a weapon can make for a miserable game since surviving will be a challenge, while picking the wrong stagger talent for a weapon can make for a frustrating game since killing will be a challenge, so be sure to double and triple check just to be sure. Number 2 is to run block cost reduction. There are many useful properties that you can run, but the most useful by far is block cost reduction. Due to enemies' higher health pool and stagger resistance, blocking and shoving is a tool you will have to utilize much more often in Legend and Cata than in the lower difficulties. Because of this, you may think that extra stamina might be the way to go, but block cost reduction mathematically gives you more bang for your buck. In addition, when running 60% block cost reduction, you can block many attacks you wouldn't normally be able to block, even with just 2 stamina shields. Number 3 is to know important breakpoints. The higher in difficulty you go, the more important breakpoints become. Breakpoints simply refer to utilizing properties and talents to help you kill things faster, and while for the most part breakpoints aren't that important outside of modded difficulties, there are a small handful of breakpoints that everyone should know which will help you immensely. One such of these is for handgun, where running just 10% power versus Skaven allows you to one-shot body shot Stormvermin, Sackrats, and Packmasters on Cataclysm. If you want to know more about breakpoints and how to use them, be sure to check out my breakpoint calculator video. Number 4 is to feel comfortable. While there is a hero power requirement on each of the difficulties to prevent you from jumping in prematurely, that doesn't mean you should instantly jump into a difficulty when you unlock it. You don't have to worry about being underpowered or underleveled since the power requirement prevents that from happening, but before jumping into a new difficulty, you should ask yourself if you're comfortable attempting to move up before you do so. A good rule of thumb to follow is to stay on a difficulty as long as you feel like it's challenging and you have to concentrate a significant amount while playing, and once that challenge begins to go away and you find yourself not concentrating as hard, you can begin that transition to the higher difficulty. And number 5 is to accept failure. The jumps between Champion to Legend and Legend to Cataclysm are the 2 hardest jumps to make in the game, so don't be surprised if you struggle at first. Strategies you used in lower difficulties may not transfer over to the higher difficulties, so be sure to accept any failures or mistakes you might make and use them as a learning experience so that you can be a stronger player next time. Remember, no one expected Rome to be built in a day, so you shouldn't expect yourself to play like Moopshark in just a day either. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed, make sure to like and subscribe for more Vermintide content in the future. See y'all next time!